The third phase of the 5Es, Explain, is designed to support students to represent and explain their developing ideas.
And then the grass is also a good place for the beetles to live.
Now we're going to have a look at some terms that
and
scientists
and to introduce the students to scientific explanations of concepts.
The first phase where teachers formally introduce current scientific thinking and understanding and vocabulary is the explain phase.
In this phase, students are firstly given the opportunity to use the experiences and data that they have collected from the explore activities to develop explanations of the concepts.
This is our explanation of the life stages of a silkworm.
These little things are the silkworms first hatching, and white ones are when they get pretty fat.
Now at this point, the students are using their own language. They may not have the correct, you know, in inverted commas, correct scientific vocabulary or the correct scientific explanations, but they can certainly talk about what they've learned, what they believe to be their understanding.
In the cocoon, something's going on with there, and it's because it like goes to sleep and then it wakes up and it's
while students are forming their explanations, the teacher monitors the students' thinking, looking for evidence of conceptual change or discrepancies between the students' conceptions and scientific ideas. This is an opportunity for formative assessment.
And it breaks it and it goes down and then it flies up.
It's a great opportunity for me to see whether they're still holding on to some non-scientific ideas.
Is there any questions?
Does a silkworm actually fly? Yes.
Who would agree with that or disagree? Who would disagree with that?
In the silkworm thing, I observed a silkworm and it was like flapping its wings really fast, but it couldn't fly.
After this, the teacher introduces the scientific ideas relating to the concept.
We're going to plug that house from the main supply and
the explanations and scientific terminology are introduced briefly, simply and clearly.
We're going to start the vibration, we're going to pass it round the circle. When you feel it, you pass on that vibration.
Each unit has teacher background information included to help teachers understand the science behind activities.
The teacher background information in the explain phase of the unit is absolutely crucial for me as a teacher.
You don't have to worry about, you know, spending long nights looking for information. It's all there and it's really succinct.
In your poster, which are producers?
Well, all the things like the wattle tree and the grass and the flowers, because they are things that all the
the teacher links current scientific ideas with the students' explanations.
Any questions of the group that are standing up here?
What would happen to your ecosystem if the cane toads arrived?
Well, if the cane toads were to arrive, they certainly eat lots of our native animals and they eat our grassland and they eat our beetles and then the birds would run out of food. Yes, basically it would be like catastrophic and everything would just collapse.
By examining their own ideas and the ideas of others, students develop the skills, knowledge and vocabulary they need to be ready for the next stage, elaborate. The purpose of the explain phase is to support students to construct explanations and use evidence to justify claims, encourage students to compare their explanations with others, introduce scientific explanations and terminology, and provide an opportunity for formative assessment.